Hello, welcome back. We are joined now by Peter Ledwidge, Managing Director at Mako Gold. Peter, good to speak to you again. How are you doing?
Doing well, thanks. Thanks for having me on again.
No problem, always a pleasure. Listen, last time we spoke a month ago, you were discussing some good results at your Gogbala prospect in Napié in Côte d'Ivoire. It looks like you've got some impressive finds now in the same project, but at a different prospect. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, so these results that we announced today are on the Tchaga prospect, which is about 3 to 4 kilometers north of Gogbala. Both of them are going to be included in the main resource. So what this was is the final drilling on Tchaga prior to the main resource. And it's all diamond drilling. Some of them were diamond tails. And what we're attempting to do there is drill a bit deeper to see the continuity of the mineralization, which obviously is a risky move for a junior explorer, but it paid off because we get some really nice intercepts, some nice broad intercepts, sometimes in various zones within. So for example, we get 41 meters in 7 zones that average about 2.85 grams per ton. The real cracker was 63 meters in about 15 zones that averages to about 1.25 grams per ton. And all of those had high grade in them. So what does that tell you from a potential mining scenario that's, you know, looking pretty good?
Yeah, give us an idea about timelines, next steps at Tchaga, and what's to come there?
Yeah, so the drilling is actually finished for the resource. So what we're doing right now is we're finishing the modeling, which is the wire framing. And then once we finish that, then we hand over that data to our resource consultants, and they can start crunching the numbers to see how many ounces we get out of that. And so that's it for Tchaga for now. Obviously, there's lots of room for growth after the main resource, but we're busy on other fronts as well.
Yeah, I mean, bring us up to date on what's been happening at Gogbala and elsewhere for you guys.
Yeah, so currently at Gogbala, we have two drills turning. So we have an RC drill turning around the clock, and then we started with a diamond drill about a week ago, and that's turning around the clock as well. So much the same as for Tchaga. So we'll keep drilling until the cutoff date so that we can crunch the numbers for the main resource. In addition to that, on the two other prospects still on the Napié permit, Tchaga North and Combo Ho. At Combo Ho, we just finished 5,000 meters of air core drilling and about 5,000 meters at Tchaga North as well. So the object of that is these big, long fences across nice soil anomalies. So these fences are anywhere from 300 meters to a kilometer long. And the object of that is to make a new discovery and then follow it up and drill it out. And that would be our next resource target. So lots of news flow. And then on our other project, Gohogo, where we've got a couple of auger rigs turning. And once we get the results from that, then we'll launch into a 10,000 meter RC drill program. So no shortages of drills turning on our projects.
Yeah, certainly building up ahead of speed. Look, you've got your MRE coming up in just a couple of months. Can you give us any updates on what to expect from that, and what else should we look out for in the coming months from Mako?
Yeah, so our maiden resource is just the start. So I'm not going to tell you what the numbers are, but, you know, ideally everybody wants you to hit 1 million ounces, and it's not likely we're going to hit 1 million ounces in a maiden resource. We haven't been drilling that long when you really think of it. So the idea is to get that maiden resource and then hopefully later in the year have an update on that maiden resource, because we put out the maiden resource, it takes about a month for the consultants to calculate that maiden resource. We're not just going to stop exploration and just sit on our hands. So we're going to keep drilling, but the drilling after the cutoff date won't be included in the maiden resource. So that means that, you know, before too long, we'll be able to update that maiden resource and get it up to 1 million ounces or more, with the longer term goal over the permit is to get, you know, 2, 3, 4 million ounces along that 30 kilometer shear.
Well, look, it certainly looks very interesting and very exciting indeed at the moment, and no doubt everyone will be on tenterhooks as we look ahead to that MRE coming up this summer. But in the meantime, thanks for talking to us as always, and we look forward to hearing back from you.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thank you.